here on Zoom is Liz Snyder from Hillside Garden Landscaping, and today you're going to share some of your favorite perennials for fall. So Liz, you know, for the last time, this is unfortunately one of our last home gardener segments, but what do you have for us, Liz?
Well, fall, there's so much beautiful color out there in the colors of the leaves on the trees, but I really wanted to share some of my favorite perennials that use some great color that last really late in the season. So the first thing that I have to share is called anemone, and it's also called windflower, and it's really a kind of a tall perennial that's very dainty, and it gets the name windflower because when it blows in the wind, it's just very soft and flowy, and it doesn't bloom until fall, which is really kind of neat. So during the summer, you have a low amount of leaves, and then that really colors up into late August, September, and into October. So it's a stunner for the end of the year. And then the second thing that I want to share is a native perennial called helenium. And there's two different kinds in the photo that I'm showing here. And what's really nice is they are very long bloomer. These can start kind of late July, early August, and they're still blooming now. They can withstand a frost or two and just look good still late in the season. And the reds, oranges, yellows, a lot of color there. The third thing is also a native perennial that can actually take quite a bit of wet if you've got a little wet area in your yard, and that is called turtlehead or chialone, and it's really a long bloomer. Again, it starts kind of at the bottom of each one of those stalks and goes up and just gives you color for a long, long time.
Awesome. Yeah, those are really beautiful. Thank you for sharing those, of course. And I know you have a couple more to share with us as well.
Yeah, but the cold days that we had last week, we had quite a bit of, you know, hard frosts, and, you know, it's kind of can be depressing that it's the end of the growing season, but one morning I went out and just took some of the most beautiful shots of the frost on the plants. The first couple of shots here I have are different kinds of nine bark. The first one is called a little devil, and then the second one is called summer wine, and when those tips of those leaves just get touched for that frost, it's so beautiful and it stands out. All the hydrangeas we have here in our display garden have been looking fabulous, and when that got a little bit of frost on it, it was beautiful as well. And the black-eyed Susans, you know, those can take a little bit of frost, but then they're just coated with those ice crystals and can look really, really neat. And the last photo I have is bee balm, which blooms a little earlier in the summer, but it's got kind of a fuzzy hairy leaf to it, so when that gets that frost out, it really stands out. Looks really
I really love the way that frost looks too.
Yeah, it's really quite beautiful if you go out in the morning in the garden early. Well, the last photo that I want to share is, you know, a lot of things when they get frosted really heavy like that a few times in a row are done for the season, but some things really can tolerate quite a bit, and then they'll even push, you know, a second bloom if you get it some warm days later on. And this photo of a clematis is just gorgeous, and I took this yesterday, and it is just blooming its little head off, and it is so pretty and such a deep burgundy color, and that plant actually has 5 or 6 more buds on it. So, you know, fingers crossed, if we get some warmer weather, then maybe that'll just keep going for the next couple of weeks.
Definitely. Well, thank you so much, Liz. All these pictures are so beautiful. And, you know, for the last time, thank you for joining us today on Around the Tiers, and, you know, looking forward to the gardening season next year. But it's been so much fun to, you know, you really taught me a lot, and it's been so much fun to have you and Jim on the show.
Thank you so much for having us. As always, it's our pleasure. So thank you for joining us. I'm Liz Snyder, your home gardener from Hillside Garden Landscaping.